In 2013, the German city of Hamburg hosted the International Building Exhibition, the IBA. 7 years in the making, the exhibition wasn't just about showcasing innovative buildings, it was about regeneration of a relatively poor neighbourhood of the city, with sustainable living in mind.
The real excess will be visible, let me say, in 5 or 7 years. But until now, today, I can say we are more successful than I would have expected for today.
So what innovation was showcased here that made it such a success? Well, first up, there was Wood Cube, a 5-storey carbon-neutral apartment block constructed almost entirely from wood and gets its power solely from photovoltaic panels.
Wood has a new boom, a new career as a construction material. And what we built 5 different wood houses with completely different technologies, but all based on wood. And that is, of course, very interesting for the different construction firms to see how people respond to these different materials, to these different technologies. And so I think we will see in future which materials, which technologies will succeed and which will fail.
And finally, the IBA showcased a world first, BIQ, a building with its own bio-reactor that runs entirely off algae. The sun-facing sides of this structure are covered with water tanks where algae bask in the light. What happens next is truly innovative. The systems designer, Martin Kerner, gives an inside look at his groundbreaking bioreactor.
What we produce here in this vessel is to burn biogas, and we produce our flue gas. And the flue gas contains CO2, and the CO2 is transferred into our culture medium by these saturation devices. So we saturate the water with flue gas, with CO2, and then transfer it back into our bioreactor facade so that the algae can take up the CO2. With this device over here, we add nutrients, that means mainly nitrogen and phosphorus, to our culture medium. With these large tubes over there at the roof, we take out the heat from the culture medium and transfer it into our heating system of the house.
But it isn't just heating that microorganisms can produce. This reactor can also farm excess amounts of algae that can be harvested for an entirely different reason.
This is rich in proteins, it's rich in unsaturated fatty acid, it contains vitamins, minerals and so on, so it's physiologically very positive. And we would like to make food and feed for animals out of this biomass.
So this bioreactor has the capability of not only heating our homes, but also of feeding our livestock.